All right, caller. What is your name, comment, and or question?
My name's Adriana Langston, and I'm calling from Long Beach, California.
Good morning. How are you this morning? It's an early morning over there.
Yes, yes, it is. But my comment is this, is about a previous show where you're talking about Syrian refugees and the painful images of the boy being washed ashore and whether or not the United States was going to wake up. And I want to say that there's a difference between being asleep and being paralyzed. And I actually wrote President Obama when the Syrian civil war was beginning and told him, I don't care how bad it gets. I don't care how many images of heartbreaking tragedy you see. Do not send one troop over there, because every time we've done that, we've made the situation worse. Mm-hmm. And the Syrians and Assad will just have to work it out. And Assad used to be supposedly an ally of the United States, and now we're going to turn around and help the rebels throw him out. I mean, so
we're good at that.
So not knowing is as much as your heart breaks at the image of these people in a meat locker. I can't even imagine suffocating with 71 other people in a meat locker truck. As much as your heart breaks for that, if you think about it and you analyze it, you might just be paralyzed, because if you bring all the facts together, you could easily be in the position I'm in, which is we really ought to stay out of this, because whatever we might do could possibly make things worse. Now, when I say whatever we might do, I'm talking about getting involved in Syria. Mm-hmm. I am not talking about bringing in more Syrian refugees. Mm-hmm. Those people have PhDs in chemistry, engineering, everything else. I welcome having more Syrian refugees come to the United States.
Okay.
So, but I don't accuse the United States of being asleep, because if people are using their brains, they might not be asleep. They might be paralyzed. And those are two different things.
Okay. All right. Thanks so much for that call. Let me dissect some of that and try to keep us on topic at the same time. So just to backtrack from the Syrian conflict and the U.S. involvement, I can see where you're coming from in terms of paralysis versus being asleep at the wheel. However, I think we still have to ask ourselves the question, as citizens of this world, how bad will we let this get? Because we cannot, you know, there's the military involvement, but then there's also the humanitarian crisis, and we can get involved in ameliorating the humanitarian crisis and not get involved with troops on the ground to fight in Syria. And I think that every nation should be involved in the humanitarian crisis. If that means that we're emptying out Syria while the rest of the idiots in Syria still fight it out, then so be it. But the rest of the world, if there are people who want to get away from Syria, then we should do everything possible. We should have boats, ships just outside of the territory waiting to help people. You know, there are a lot of things that our military can do that does not involve weapons, because every time we pull our guns in the Middle East, I agree with you, we make it absolutely worse. And that's the question that I want to tie back to the comment, rather, that I want to tie back to Donald Trump. It's not a question of whether or not we can beat them. There is not a nation that we cannot beat. Some will cost us more than others, right? You know, if we try to beat China, or we try to beat Russia, or if Russia and China try to beat us, then there's likely going to be World War III with mutually assured destruction. There is a cost, but we would win, right? The question is, should we get involved on that level? And they're not asking themselves this question. They're just, you know, they're trying to fuel their bravado, and particularly Donald Trump, and trying to say that if there's a fight, then America needs to be in it. And that's the type of absurdity that we absolutely have to keep away from the White House.